Hi, my name is Jerry Ramos. I'm from NAPCC, Home Position D. And what you see here is the Floor Management Development System Board, also known as the FMDS board. In this video, I'll be providing an example on how to properly use this board. My focus on this board will be the quality section. Some objectives of the FMDS board are to make floor abnormalities easy to see, to help team members identify and solve problems using provided tools, create effective charts and graphs to tell a story, create a common practice of floor management, increase the skill and utilization of problem-solving methods, improve data analysis to drive quick and repetitive problem-solving, to keep home position team members informed of activities and progress. What you have here is the quotient for your home position, followed by your main KPI, your sub-KPI, your analysis, the activities, and finally your results. You have your global quotient, your SPA quotient, your SPAO quotient, your facility quotient, and finally your group, which is your home position FMDS. You have your main KPI and your sub KPI. NAPCC quotient, calendar year 18. Customer and quality, KPI targets, 30% reduction in errors, damages, and non-scan MUs. Key activities: deployment of piece-by-piece scan, deployment of customer quality dojo. Main KPI: errors, 446 lines per million. Damages, 11.6 pieces per million. Non-scan MUs, 1.7 for every 10,000. Home position D being a bulk home position, our volume doesn't justify using lines per million or pieces per million. Instead, we target actual errors and actual damages. We find this to be more beneficial for the customer and to help us better target Kaizens. This is Home Position D's quality main KPI in graph form. We find a graph format gives us a better understanding on how we are trending and where we should focus our Kaizen effort. Damages are in blue, SMRs are in green. We currently do not have any non-scan MUs. If we did, they would be in yellow. We took the damage information from January to May. We used that information for the sub KPI. In the sub KPI, the damages are broken down by zone. C is green, D is yellow, G is blue, K is gray, and brown is others. The FMDS board guided us to look at our damages. Home position D had 29 damages from January to May. We broke those down by zone. Z zone being the highest with 12. We broke down our C zone damages by part commodity, 2 grills and 10 hand lamps. Then we broke down the 10 hand lamp damages by part number. That led us to part number 81150-04270. It made up 30% of our headlamp damages for home position D. As part of our investigation, we opened the headlamp boxes to verify how parts were packaged. We reached out to our field operations improvement manager to get the national damage report. We discovered that this part number was not only Home Position D highest damage claim, but it was also all of the PDC's highest damage claim for headlamps. We discovered that parts needed better protection on the ends. Not enough protection was causing the part to move and get damaged. We submitted a PPR for the concern. We also discovered that in Home Position D, the parts were not being stored with directional arrows up. Countermeasures. We reduced the number of parts in the location to assure the directional arrows were followed. We verified there was a packaging change to reduce the damage. The packaging was changed to a larger box to give headlamps more room. The wrapping process improved to ensure 3 wrap points to prevent part movement. Directional arrows were added to indicate best shipping and storage orientation. Since these implementations, we have not received a damage claim for this part number. By targeting one part number, Home Position D was able to reduce headlamps damage by 30%. That led Home Position D to reduce the overall damages by 11%. No matter how small your target might be, if you use FMDS properly, it will ultimately make an impact in helping reach our global quotient and better service our customer. Remember, if there's no activity, then there will be no result.